Dad.
Answer me, Dad. Answer me, Dad. Your own blood. What the hell were you thinking? What in the hell crossed your mind? What the fuck is happening?
Dad, please, please talk to me. I don't understand what's going on.
No, no. This can't be happening. God.
Son.
Come on. Maybe I can get out through Grandpa's house. I gotta get out of here. I need to find a way out before Dad notices I'm here. Wasn't there a door here? My birthday present? How did it get here? Just like Dad. What? It must be broken. Thank you. What the hell has Dad been doing here? Dad said he was repairing Grandpa's house, but instead he's been investigating this woman? What is going on? The storm must have taken out the power. I think Grandpa had a generator in the basement. Grandma and Grandpa's room.
From the moment of first contact, it is already too late. When a demon attaches itself to a human,
demons?
It becomes a parasite of sorts. It feeds from the host until it devours every last part of their soul. In most instances, the demon's relentless objective is to get back to the world of the living. If you want to break that link, well, I'm afraid it's no simple matter. I could speak at length about various rituals and procedures, but by far the best way is to obey. Help the demon attain that which it seeks. Only then will the demon leave of its own accord. Usually they enter the earthly plane through certain objects that they use as conduits between worlds. Even if you rid yourself of that object later, the demon has made the contact it needs and already walks among us. In the first stages of possession, the host human tends to withdraw from friends and family, becoming aggressive, even violent. This is the result of the spiritual battle between the host and the entity, both vying for control over the mortal body. The symptoms that indicate that the possession is progressing are dizziness, nausea, and headaches. The latter of which can be so intense as to render the host unconscious for days. The dark entity manipulates its host with visual hallucinations and voices in the mind. Destroying the sanity of the host is for the purpose of making them malleable, compliant. This is how the demon fully exerts its insidious control. Oh, and before I forget, Several cases of possession saw strange behavioral patterns in nearby insects. Cockroaches in particular. My advice, steer clear of the insects.
There's just no way. I can't be possessed. There must be a mistake. Those pictures, that leg, that arm, I didn't do it. Dad thinks it was me, but I... Oh, God. My head. A door. A red door. What's happening to me? Is this what that man was talking about? It can't be happening to me. Could it be the basement door? What? What is this place? This is impossible. What's wrong with me? Be able to open it easily.
Officer Russell here. June 17th, 1987, 5:27 a.m. I am now entering MADiSON Hill's basement.
Hill? 1987?
I can see there's a sort of well in the center of the room. Looks like it's open. I'm gonna investigate further, see what's on the other side of this.
Happening to me. I gotta get the hell out of. I don't understand. My Been here before.
A 43-year-old woman was killed by a police officer.
The 43-year-old woman was killed by a police officer. smells awful. The pipes must be clogged. The entrance key should be somewhere. Why would he keep all this? Grandma died a long time ago. There are meds everywhere. She was so sick. What are these things? There's definitely someone here. Photos are pretty old. Huh. Papa's office. Tried to contact Grandma with this thing? Is that blood?
Becoming possessed by a wicked entity is signified by a loss of control over the body, mind, and the soul. However, that is often not enough for the entity. It hungers for more. Things get much worse for the host. In these cases, possession is just the first step of the demon's plan. It is said there are those that return to our world seeking to resolve unfinished matters from their mortal lives. Victims of these wicked possessions are subjected to a departure of sorts. An astral transportation, for lack of a better word.
An astral what?
These malicious beings force their hosts to live moments that shouldn't be possible in a different place and time, perhaps even in a different dimension altogether. It's madness. It's unclear whether these transportations occur inside the mind, or if the host is physically taken to some alternative reality.
Alternative reality? I'm losing my mind. happening in this house? There are handprints on the walls. prison stopped. How did I get here? I hate graveyards. What am I doing? God. This goes down really deep. Ah! God. How did I end up here? Thank you. This is impossible. This place didn't look like this a second ago.
Crimes. He knew he couldn't stay in Germany. He knew his past was coming to get him. He knew it. He tried to pretend it was all gone, but it was gone. It chased him. It haunted him. It haunted me. Father, you have to understand. He was in charge of a gas chamber. He took so many innocent lives and destroyed them. There were days I would look into his eyes and I would see a void, emptiness, nothing looking back at me. He was already dead. Only God knows how many lives he had taken, but not anymore. I made sure he would not hurt another person. I made sure that he suffered.
On earth as it is in heaven. Our Father in heaven, hallowed.
What the fuck was that? I gotta get out of this place. Of life, the color of peace, the color of our little angels.
Thank you.
Hans Goring? Son, Hale? Is this her coffin? The eye is missing. MADiSON Hale.
is trying to go beyond even that. We are speaking of an ancient ritual, of which very little is known. 7 sacrifices, 7 mutilations.
7?
I believe we are facing a body exchange type of ritual. MADiSON Hale was trying to complete such a ritual before she was murdered, and now she is forcing your child to finish it for her. She is trying to steal your son's body. Call me as soon as you get this message.
Is that what she's after? Something else under that plank. Thank you. that woman. She doesn't show in the photos. And somehow, the photos of her... that they were... the ring she mentioned in her diary?
God. My eyes. My eyes burn. God. I need to get out of this fucking house.
Do not listen. Chains? Maybe I can break them with something. I'm carrying too much already. Where did these come from? Body exchange ritual? I need to put an end to this. Grandma's diary. There must be something useful here. These must be MADiSON's victims.
John, I must stress to you how dangerous these demons really are. I've witnessed a few exorcisms in my time. Not everyone lived to tell the tale. These beings are not alive, and that makes them stronger than us. They entertain themselves with us. They enjoy our fear, causing us pain. They feed off of it. It gives them power, gives them strength. When one of them becomes attached to one of us, it's all but impossible to stop. They play with our bodies and minds.
Does this mean that...
until they find what they were looking for.
That woman is attached to
the
camera?
They're no longer human.
Attached to me?
They are beyond everything we know. John, I implore
you. She's no longer human.
Seek help. I'll investigate that woman you told me about. MADiSON Hale. And I'll get back to you as soon as I find something. Keep all of this information away from your son. Get rid of that camera as soon as you get this message, but please, please do be careful. If your child has already had contact with this entity, his life, yours, and your family's are
Mom,
in jeopardy.
Chanel, what have I done? I need to find a way to end this. Fuck. It burns. My body burns. Horns? I think I've seen something like this in the house. No, not again. No. Fuck. I can't feel my fingers. What is happening to my body? I don't know what this could mean. There was a red light, but everything was dark. The doorbell. I gotta get to the front door. She's playing with my mind. There is no fucking
victims. Apparently, the woman photographed the corpses while mutilating them. It is still unclear whether the photos were part of the rites she was carrying out, or if she simply took them at the well along with the other corpses. So far, his left leg and three fingers have not been found.
I wonder what these numbers are for.
The first victim was her own 75-year-old father. MADiSON mutilated his body in such a way that his face was unrecognizable. His body was found.
Sounds like something he's doing.
So far, his left leg and three fingers have not been found. The first victim was her own 75-year-old father. MADiSON mutilated his body in such a way that his face was unrecognizable. The victim was her 71-year-old mother. According to police reports, MADiSON amputated both of her legs while she was still alive. The woman passed away due to great loss of blood. Hours later, MADiSON continued to mutilate her body before disposing of it. The second victim was her 71-year-old mother. According to police reports, MADiSON amputated both of her legs while she was still alive.
Maybe I can break the wall with something.
MADiSON stabbed her at her own front door. Neighbors neighbors witnessed her dragging the body into the house and notified the police. The woman's body was found, unrecognizable, in more than 13 pieces. The victim was a 35-year-old woman. MADiSON stabbed her at her own front door. Neighbors witnessed her dragging the body into the house and notified the police. Witnessed her dragging the body into the house and notified the police. The woman's body was found, unrecognizable, in more than 13 pieces. The final victim was a 35-year-old woman. MADiSON stabbed her.
To make room first.
still losing my mind.
Grandma?
I cannot trust anyone. Not even Albert. If you are listening to this, Blue Knees is real.
Blue Knees?
I know I'm not sick. And I know I don't have much time left. The fucking thing. I can feel it breathing right behind me. Singing that fucking song. Over and over and over and over. And over in my head. Oh. Blue Knees is behind and will find what he's been looking for so long, all alone where he belongs. Oh, Blue Knees is behind and will find what he has been looking for. Old kitchen where he's written this. Just for you.
God, my body, my hands, this is what the priest was talking about. That thing is feeding off of me. What the fuck does this even mean? The house is full of clocks. To work in here.
How many times do I have to tell you nobody in this house?
Al.
I'm done with your bullshit.
Albert, listen to me.
Just a book. A fucking book, Elizabeth. See? There's no one here. It doesn't exist. It's not real, goddammit.
I know. Everything that's happening to me has something to do with it. I just know it.
It's a disease, Elizabeth. You are sick, for the Lord's sake.
I'm not sick.
You'll end up losing your mind if you don't cut the crap. This book has nothing to do with your illness. I wish you'd stop acting like a child. Stop hiding our stuff and take your goddamn pill.
Do you think it's normal? Do you think pupils vanish like dust? I'm telling you that fucking thing is what's causing
Enough,
this for me!
Elizabeth! Stop acting like a 10-year-old and go to bed!
Albert! Everything started the day we brought that fucking book to this house!
It's a disease, Elizabeth.
If you don't believe me, I will leave this place. I'm done. And I'm taking Johnny with me. We are not staying here.
Wait a minute. No paranoia. Go back to bed before we wake up Johnny. Come on.
You're gonna regret this. You'll end up all alone. Just you and your stupid fucking clock.
seems like he never finished this one. I can't take this anymore. I just can't. My whole body is going numb. Why is this happening to me? This must be a combination or something. This used to be Dad's room. What happened in here? So this is the book that everyone was talking about? The room has changed. I know this is impossible, but I think Dad wrote this. So Grandma wasn't sick at all. This thing is what really killed her.
Oh!